Guten Morgen, this is Giuseppe Basile. I'm the analyst in trading for the blog FibStalker.com. I also post regularly on Twitter using the FibStalker nickname. Good morning. Today is June 6, 2013. It's 10 to 9 a.m. Toronto time. I have completed my relocation to Canada, and I'm actually doing this analysis for the S&P 500, the E-mini futures from Toronto. And what you see on the screen is the daily chart of this contract. This is the continuous contract aligned to the June 2013 expiration. And those who follow me know that I've been actually timing the reversal of this instrument here, and the S&P 500 is in a actually was in a sequence of extension higher, and the first sequence of these extensions extension has been this traditional with supporting the 1347 area. It never pierced the 1321 level, and as we can see, price got into the 1507 level, and again it went to hit the 1591 level, almost to the tick here. And then you see this this reaction lower at this profit taking, meaning that these levels are very powerful, and program trading and professional traders are actually taking profits at these levels. Now, the next level I've indicated was this trace from highs to highs, but if you go back and review my analysis, and as you can see from the chart as well, price never touched this 1525 level, and the reason is in the level I'm using. Actually, if you use other platforms like Swim, for example, TOS, or also other Italian platforms, but also other trading platforms, the level they report here, this high in September, is not 1456, but TOS for example it's 4,067, and I also saw platform providing the 1474. So if you use my levels, then you could not enter here, so you should use another strategy to entry here, and I have a strategy to enter in this situation, the 4-hour chart. But if we consider the 1467 or 74, then there would have been here a precise setup if I use the TOS Tinkoswim level here. I would have had this 1530 level with a stop 15 points below. What happened is that anyway, as we can see, this setup, and I will also draw my original setup here. They both brought price into the first target. These two setups, they both brought the target into the first target and then the second target. And if those who follow me will remember that on this day, the May the 21st, I've traced another measure move, and I said that we would see some kind of reaction at the 1633 area, and as you can see, it almost to the point, the pip, sorry, to the tick here, and also provided this scenario, which we could retest highs and then eventually move lower. For me, the key and the trigger was for price to break this 1623-22 level here, and that happened. And and so we started this move lower. We know that I anticipate this not to be the start of the actual move, the actual bear market move lower, which could be bring price again into the 600 area here. But what I anticipate this to be is a first move lower, which would draw in bears, and then there would be another move higher. A potential level where we could correct is this 1507 level, and we could get here and get some participation, bring price back to these highs, and maybe even slightly higher highs here before we start the actual move over. I want to show you the weekly chart, because I want to show you something very interesting, and another proof, if you still need it, that this market are governed by program trading, and especially of course on the larger time frame. So the larger the time frame, the more lasting and important effect is provided by the activity of program trading. So if you look at this anchor here, which would only be identified after the fact, after price reacted to this 967 level, and it was a first reaction here on end of May 2010 here, then we could say this level could be important and could be used by program trading. And indeed, if you reused, I'm gonna trace this again. If you trace from here to the high in 2010, you would see that price would go then to this 1237 target. So reusing the same anchor to new highs, because we didn't reach the second target. You see, that's the importance of program observing the behavior of program trading. Excuse me. And there was a participation here in this one, starting at 1056 level. Price never went below 992. And again, look at this. Look at the profit taking the 1454 level. And eventually price continued higher, and within this move there were inner measures move like the one I've showed you on the daily time frame. But I'm not going to comment on this. I already commented on the daily chart. But see, again, when price got into the 1660 level, then we had some reaction lower. So this this market structure here, price structure and market behavior, is showing that we have three levels we have to watch where we could get this potential which could actually stop this potential move lower. And one would be the largest would be the 1360 level. And then we have two level generated by extension long, and the first one would be from 2011 May highs, and that would be the 1506-07, which is the one I've showed you before on the daily chart. And then there would be also another level, which is actually generated by other extensions higher. So and traditional moves higher, and this would be the level from the lows in in August year two highs. And this will give us the 1,462. So we don't know where this market will stop. To me, it looks like 1,360 could be too far away, but would actually be a possible level. And for sure, we're going to get some sort of reaction initially at this 1,407, and maybe we will then move down into the 1,460 area. So that's it for my forecast of the S&P E-mini futures price based on observation of what current trading is doing on the largest time frames. I hope this this video is useful. I think that this market could come back to one of these two levels, the old way or way back here, and this would be a very, very, very good entry shorts in this market if the market gets back there. Even if this 1,656 level is pierced, I think this market has still some move down to complete, as I said, at least towards and to this 1,507 level. Price could also not reach that level and just stop at the 1,640 level, which with a stop above 1,656 could be a good entry, with resistance on the 200-day move, the 20-day 20-day moving average here. So it's exciting. There could be 140 points here to be taken if you are not already short. Thank you very much for your attention, and have a great day. Bye bye.